And suppose this is a conductor. In this conductor, you know well, if you are having free electrons, then electrons will move in this direction because of potential difference, and effect of this movement will be the current in opposite direction. And current formula I is equal to rate of flow of charge with respect to time. But the problem is how to understand why these electrons are free in the conductor, because I can make you confused, because you know we know like electrons are revolving around the nucleus. If you have a nucleus, then these electrons will revolve around the nucleus. So if electrons are revolving around the nucleus, then how can they move in a conductor? Then definitely there is something, right? Then only they are moving in the conductor. At the same time, electrons are revolving around the nucleus also, and I am saying they are moving also in front. How it can be possible? So definitely there is something. That something is, see, suppose you have a nucleus here and you have the orbit here. In the orbit, electrons are revolving around the nucleus. So they are actually attracted towards the nucleus. That's why they are not able to free. To be free to, okay, so what to do? If suppose electron will get energy from somewhere somehow, and this electron after getting the energy will be sufficiently energetic and it will leave the nucleus and it will be free from the atom. So suppose this total big size of the atom and this electron became free. So it will not jump out of the conductor, it will be inside the conductor only, but it will be free. Like fishes, they are in the river, okay, they swim in the river. In same way, these electrons will be swimming randomly in the conductor. Okay, so now till the time when electron was revolving around the nucleus, they were known as valence band electrons. Valence band electrons. And once they are free, then they are known as free electrons. So now we got free electrons, and these free electrons are responsible to move in the conductor, okay, to create the current. The revolving electrons are not creating current. The free electrons, they are moving. How are they being free? You got the idea, right? Once they are getting the energy, then only they are being free. Who will give them energy? In the conductor, in the semiconductor, in the insulator, all are having separate cases. In case of conductor, our thermal energy, I mean whatever heat is there at room temperature, that heat energy is sufficient to make them free from their own nucleus. Okay, so if you have the nucleus and electrons are free now, then these electrons, so suppose you have a conductor, and now in the conductor you have some random electrons. Now before, earlier, because they are free, so they can rotate in, they can move in any direction. Now if you want to produce the current, then what to do? If you have a conductor here and you have electrons here, then put some potential difference here. So if you are having potential difference, then electrons will move in this direction. Always remember, electron moves towards higher potential and remaining current will move in this direction. I hope you are clear. So current I is equal to Q by T. What is Q? Q is the number of charge, amount of charge, and unit of Q is coulomb, unit of time is second. Now Q means what? What was the Q? Q was charge, but in case of electrons, how will you say the charge? You know, Q value is N times of E. What is N? Total number of electrons here, okay, passing through the cross section every second. Means how many electrons are passing every second from any cross section. In a wire, you have a lot of electrons. That total number of electrons we don't want. We want that much amount of electron which is passing every second from a cross section. I hope you are clear, right? I mean to say, suppose you have a conductor here. In the conductor, you have lot of electrons. But through this cross section, every second, how many electrons are passing? That is N. N is the number of electrons into E. What is E? Is the electronic charge. If you'll multiply number with electronic charge, you'll be getting total charge, that is Q, and divide by time. Total time they will mention in the question, or it is different. You know, it depends on your idea. It will mention the question. I hope you're getting. So that's why we say current I as rate of flow of charge per second. And same thing goes with ions also. In case of liquid state, ions are responsible. Only in solids, currents are flowing. Current is flowing because of electronic charge, because of electron flow. And remember one more thing. Here I have explained only about conduction current. There is something called displacement current. If you are 12th student, 12th class student, then you will be knowing about displacement current from your teacher. If you want, I'll explain. Thank you.